Claude Sports Corner here for June 7th, 2016. And trust me, you're about to hear him in the background. And it would have been his 58th birthday if he was alive today. And that is one Prince Rogers Nelson. But this particular segment is not about him. It's about a recently departed icon in his own right. In fact, an even bigger icon when it comes worldwide. And he was much bigger than any other athlete in any professional sport. The late, great Muhammad Ali. I'm doing this segment because it's very funny how there is a love fest, so to speak, between Ali and the public. And I'm talking about the world public, but especially here in the United States of America. When, of course, any of us that are old enough to know, and I'm not one of those. In fact, I was actually born a little bit after that. But all the people who were around in the mid to late 60s know that Ali was vilified in this country. In fact, he was vilified by the very black people that should have stood by him, knowing the Jim Crow racist system that was set up in the United States of America, especially back in that time. Now, I can make the case that it's a more dangerous time now, but I digress. Well, these are two of his biggest adversaries, and they are very prominent when it comes to black history and black sports history in general. Here's the very first quote. "I'm sorry that he's done it," meaning Ali. "I respect Cassius." Notice how he disrespected him by still calling him by his slave name, Cassius Clay. "I respect Cassius as one of the greatest fighters of all time. I hope that the American people will understand that this is an act of one man, not an act of all Negroes in this country." The person who made that statement was one Jackie Robinson. In fact, I'm wearing his jersey right now. It's very disappointing that he, who went through hell breaking the color barrier in Major League Baseball, would go against Ali when he broke an even bigger barrier when it comes to the young people for the United States of America, both black and white, who were conscientiously objecting this war. And in fact, it was a terrible war that we had no business fighting in. Here is the second quote by another very prominent black man back in that time. In fact, his criticism of Muhammad Ali was much more scathing. "I'm against black Muslims. I've always believed that every man is my brother. Clay will earn the public's hatred because of his connections with the black Muslims. The things they preach are just the opposite of what we believe." Notice how he used the term "we believe." Real well-trained house Negro in the Willie Lynch style. "We sick massa? See, is we's okay? How we's gonna do today?" Real house Negro this man is. But in finishing up his statement, "The heavyweight champion should be a champion of all people. He has responsibilities to all people. Clay has $1 million worth of confidence and a dime's worth of courage. He can't punch, he can't hurt you, and I don't think he takes a good punch. If you haven't figured it out, that man was one Joe Louis, who fought in the segregated army as well as Jackie Robinson, and owed a hell of a lot of taxes, was treated very shabbily by this country, and died broken penniless, and had to have one Frank Sinatra pay for his funeral. And I'm not letting Jackie Robinson off the hook so quickly either. Jackie Robinson proved his worth as a step-and-fetching house Negro way back in the 40s as well, because he bit the very man who opened the barrier for him, one Paul Robeson, who in 1943 went to baseball's committee and fought to have a black man break the color barrier, and in fact was very close to Jackie Robinson. But what did Jackie Robinson do? He did what very many of our people do. Do the crab in the barrel mentality. And it also goes on to say In 1949, Jackie Robinson denounced Paul Robeson before the House of Un-American Activities Committee. And one of the chairmen of that particular committee was a guy that Jackie Robinson would ally himself with, one Richard M. Nixon, who, as we know, how his presidency turned out was very bad for black Americans and Americans in general. Now, I got this particular quote from The Wrap. That's a particular newspaper, which you can look up. And that particular date was April 11th, 2013, and it was written by one David Robb. The quote that I got for Joe Lewis was done from a book called Muhammad Ali, His Life and Times by one Thomas Hauser. Now, the quote from Jackie Robinson was from a book, ironically, about Howard Cosell called There You Have It, The Life, Legacy, and Legend of Howard Cosell, written by John Bloom. Black people, we need to stop this crab in a barrel mentality. And let's face it, those two men fell painfully short to what Ali became. A man that people of all races could look up to. This is Claude Sports Corner. Please like and subscribe. Take care and God bless.